Hi you guys, it's Dainelly Iniguez and welcome back to my channel. If you want to know how to recreate this Halloween Egypt look, then just keep on watching. Okay, so I'm gonna go on with the Pixi Glow Tonic. I got it from Target. As you get like a little cloth, I got this one at Target too. You just put a little bit on there so your makeup doesn't crack around your nose and your chin area. So just like put it on your skin. Make sure you can really get it under your chin and between your nose. It takes your dead skin cells off too, and it gives your skin a bright glow. Then I'm gonna go in with this moisturizer. I saw Nikita Dragon put it on her Snapchat, so I was like, ooh, let's get it. It's really good, and it tingles my skin, which I don't know if that's a good thing, but it feels really good. Okay, so I did one brow off camera. I will be doing the other brow. And then I used the Anastasia Beverly Hills pencil in medium brown. So I outlined it the darkest on the bottom line. I don't even really have eyebrows. Okay, and now I'm gonna clean it up with my Tarte Shape Tape Concealer in the shade Light. So I'm gonna use a little Real Techniques brush. Came in a little 3-set to clean up my eyebrow. And for the top, to make it look more natural, go in with your foundation. Today I'm using the Makeup Forever HD foundation, so I'm going to use that to clean up on top of my brow. I will have everything that I use in the description down below, so if I don't say it, you can find it down there. I'm going to go on a more box light in the middle, like in these are the corners. They're not gonna be so faded because this is like an Egyptian tutorial, so we want them more boxy. Okay, so I just blended the concealer and the foundation on top to make it a little bit darker because we do want them darker than usual. I'm gonna use this little brush. It came in a set from BH Cosmetics. Check them out because they have a lot of sales. So wherever you drew your eyebrow, I'm just gonna put it right on top. Nothing crazy. Even darker. And then with the spoolie, I'm just gonna go back and distribute the product evenly. Shout out to my sister-in-law for letting me borrow her mirror, by the way. You're gonna watch this. Okay, so I did one eye off camera. So to prime my eye, I'm gonna go with the MAC Soft Ochre Paint Pop. I'm just gonna put it all over the lid with the BH Cosmetics brush as well. You're gonna drag it in here in the middle and inside too, because we're gonna put eyeshadows. Yeah, Real Techniques brush, just blend it. That's how I do it, so.
broken now. I'm gonna fix it Tuesday. I'm gonna go in with this palette from the Juvia's Place. They actually have it on sale for like $18 or $20, so go ahead and check that out. You can use a discount Nikki. I'll put it down in the description below as well to get some money off. Then I'm gonna go in with this flat brush from BH Cosmetics. If you do not have this brush, do not hesitate. Find something similar. I'm going based off a twirl that I saw. I'm switching it up, but she uses like a Sigma one and I'm using a BH, so it doesn't matter. Just whatever you can use, go ahead and use it. And I'm gonna go in with this shade, like the burnt orange shade from this palette. Top off the excess. I'm gonna put it right in the middle, sort of the cut crease line. It's gonna look a little weird in the beginning, but don't freak out. Just have patience and work with it. Just be patient and work with it. Grab a blending brush. I'm using the Morphe 330. I'm just gonna buff it out. With the Morphe 433, I'm gonna pick up more of that orange, tap off the excess, and just go on top of my crease. I really want you to be able to see the orange. And then just drag it out. Which is blend windshield wiper motions until you're satisfied with how the orange looks. You want it light, that's fine, but I want it a little bit more dark. So back with the Real Techniques brush, and I usually cut my crease with concealer, but for this look, I will be cutting it again with the MAC Soft Ochre Paint Pot. Just a little thing different. Wanna spice it up for you guys. It looks hard, but it's okay. Not so hard. Pretty easy. My watery, sorry. And then with this Kylie brush, I'm just gonna grab this gold from the palette. If you do not have this brush, like I said, get something that looks like it. Don't hesitate. I'm gonna grab it on my brush, apply it on my lip, exactly where I put that paint pot. Every week, be more consistent for you guys. We're actually going to be filming the spicy noodle challenge for y'all probably tonight or tomorrow, so expect that up on my channel as well. And then I found in the tutorial that I saw, they use like a different liner, but I wanted something more affordable that y'all can grab at Ulta or whatever. So I found this Revlon. It's like a color stay liner. You just want it to look like this. And I wanted to go more on the sort of cheaper side for this look, or something that I can just grab close by. But I'm just gonna put my little angled brush in there. Oh, I'm nervous. Okay. So you're gonna get the line all the way up. Do not get scared if it's too long or whatever, because we're gonna have a makeup wipe to clean it. So since we did the line, you're basically in the clear zone. So just grab like a regular wing aligner. Thicker than usual. This liner, you're gonna have to work with it though. I thought it was gonna be more easier, but it's okay. It got the job done. I got the look that I was looking for. Okay. Be patient. So as I was dragging it up, what we're gonna do, instead of keep dragging it up, we're gonna drag it down. And over. Like I said, do not hesitate so much on the lines. We will use a wipey to clean it up. So my eyes so watery. With more of that liner, I want a little bit more black. It wasn't as black as I thought it was gonna be, but it's okay, we'll work with it. Okay. And now it's gonna get a little bit bigger on the front. I was struggling to see for a little bit because my eyes are so watery, but it's okay. We'll make it work. So just with this little small detailed brush, I'm going to grab the black from this palette and just put it on to give it that depth effect. Like a fading effect. There you go. And then I'm gonna go in with this heavy metal glitter I got at Ulta. No, I got this one at Sephora, but they do sell it at Ulta. And you're gonna put it all over where you put that gold. And with a makeup wipe, we're gonna clean under the eye. Okay, well don't go too far. This is what I think is gonna happen to you. So funny. It's okay. Mistakes will happen. There you go. That's it. Just drew it back on. Yeah, so just if you struggle, it's okay to mess up. You saw me mess up, but I fixed it. Don't get too scared if you mess up. And then with the burnt orange that we use on top of the crease will be used with the like flat brush. And we're going to do it under the waterline just so I can help you where you're going to put that black liner. Oh, wait. I forgot. Sorry. I'm going to put concealer. I was like, I forgot something. Doing like a evil dark queen next week for sure, but I want to at least try to get like another video, not something too basic either. I want something that's going to be a little
different. Just so I can show y'all how I would do it. And show y'all how to do it. If you have no clue. Okay. I'm gonna get some of that liner again. And connect it from the bottom. Okay, I tried it with this little angle brush to do the cat in the middle. I don't like it, but I'm not the best at it. But I will try for y'all. Oh, Jesus. Makes me more nervous. I suck at this. Oh, my God. I don't know. It always just really reminds me of Leo. We're gonna go in to give it a pop of color. Okay, so I got this new Maybelline Metallic Liner. This is in the shade, Teal Galaxy. I'm gonna put it right under my eye to give it that effect. It's so pretty. Okay, so I'm gonna have to switch to voiceover only because my daughter just walked in the room and she's sick. I don't want to, like, for y'all not to hear me when I say a product or anything. So from here, I'm going down to voiceover. So I will be telling y'all step by step as I do the voiceover.
Okay, so here I'm just cleaning up my liner with concealer to make sure everything looks neat. Okay, so here I'm picking up the Venus Lashes by Coco Lashes. Okay, so here I'm picking up the Professional to minimize my pores. Okay, so here I'm picking up the Mario Badescu spray. So next, I will be picking up the Smashbox primer. This is highly recommended if you are oily in your T-zone on your nose. This is so perfect for that. Okay, so here I will be spraying my face with the Smashbox water primer. Okay, then here I will be using my Makeup Forever Ultra HD stick. I swear this foundation gives you so much coverage. Okay, and then as you see, I will be using some of the Muddy Body oil. I love to mix this with my foundation. It just keeps my skin hydrated and looking healthy. Okay, so here I am highlighting my face with the Tarte Shape Tape. If you do not have this concealer and want full coverage, go ahead and get this. This is at Ulta, Sephora. Girl, you need this. Then picking up some RCMA No Color Powder, I'll be setting my face. I love this powder and it's so affordable. Okay, so here I am just brushing off the excess. I'll be picking up my Kat Von D contour kit. I love this contour palette. It's one of my favorites. So here I picked up the Morphe blush palette. Okay, with one of the light shades from the Kat Von D palette, I will be cleaning up under my contour. Okay, for my lips, I will be using Mary Jo K from the Kylie Cosmetics. I love, love, love her lip kits. They're awesome. Okay, so one of my tips and tricks is that I clean up if I mess up on the edges of my lipstick with foundation. Okay, so here I will be putting some of the Kylie Poppin' Gloss in the center, and I also get a little bit of that gold shade that I put on my eyelid in the center as well. And that's it. Okay, so that is it for this tutorial. Please do not forget to subscribe, and if you do recreate this look, please tag me. I would love to see